स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू डीएवी मॉडल पब्लिक स्कूल सीता सावंगी। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डील विथ नरेशन, इट मींस डायरेक्ट एंड इनडायरेक्ट स्पीच। इन आवर अर्लियर क्लास वी हैव सीन ऑल द टर्म, ऑल द थिंग्स, रूल्स टू कन्वर्ट डायरेक्ट स्पीच इनटू इनडायरेक्ट स्पीच। आई होप यू हैव रिवाइज्ड इट, सो लेट्स डू रिविजन। डायरेक्ट एंड इनडायरेक्ट स्पीच, the words showing nearness of time or of place in indirect speech are changed into the words showing distance of time or place in indirect speech as follows. In our earlier class we have already seen that how to convert direct speech into indirect speech. So along with these other rules, keep these things in your mind. If you see these words in a direct speech, these, here, now, that will be converted into that, those, there, then, this, that, these, those, here, there, now, then. The word showing nearness of time or place in direct speech are changed into the word showing distance of time or place in indirect speech as follows. Today, that day. Tonight, that night. Tomorrow, the day after. Yesterday, the day before. Why? When do you said, when do you told? Now see, remember the rules for the use of the reporting verb say and tell. We use tell if the reporting verb is followed by name of the person or pronoun used for that person being spoken to in direct speech. Karan said it to me. So student, you have to see after said, if there is an object, Karan said to me or Karan said to him, that time you have to use told. But if there is no object, then you should not use told. Now see the sentence. Karan said to me, you should participate. Karan told me that I should participate in the competition. However, when the person is being spoken to is not mentioned after the reporting verb, as we say, Karan said it is holiday. Okay, now Karan is saying, okay, but there is no object. So here you can write down, Karan said that it was a holiday. Okay, so whenever you will find the object, you have to use told. But if there is no object in after reporting verb, then you have to use said. Okay, no, don't need to add told if you don't get this reporting verb, and after that reporting verb, if you don't see object directly, you can write down said that. But if you see the object, then you have to use told. For changing interrogative sentence into indirect speech, the following rules are to be followed. Interrogative sentence, you know, the sentence which ask a question and expect it to be answered. WH type question are all interrogative. WHO, WH and HO. In reporting question in indirect speech, the introductory verb is changed. Ask, inquire, demand, some other words using a similar meaning. For example, see the word, the same word is used for introducing the reported speech. If the question begins with an interrogative pronoun or adverb, such as what, who, which, whom, when, where, how, why. Vinod said to me, do you play football? Vinod asked, if I played football. This is a yes no type question also. And whenever you find any interrogative sentence, begin with do. Join the sentence by using if. Imperative sentences. In reporting commands and requests, the indirect speech is introduced by some words expressing command or request, and the imperative mode is changed into infinitive. Infinitive means used to before main verb. Imperative sentence means the sentence which gives command, order or request. How to convert that imperative sentence into indirect speech? We use words expressing command or request as the reporting verb, order, commanded, shouted or demanded. Shut the door, mother said. Mother order us to shut the door. Aditya said to Raman, please help me. Aditya requested Raman to help her. Okay, students, so imperative, if after reporting verb, if you get direct speech in imperative sentence, for example, open the door. Manish said, open the door. Manish requested me to open the door. So simply you have to add to before the verb. Don't need to change the sentence. Okay, students? So keep all these rules in your mind and solve all the exercises of this direct and indirect speech, and write down these rules in your notebooks. Thank you, dear students. Have a happy day.